हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज़ अल्पा रुपाला, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एल जी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, कंप्यूटर डिपार्टमेंट। वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मोबाइल कंप्यूटिंग एंड वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन, यूनिट नंबर 3, सब टॉपिक मोबाइल आईपी। टॉपिक्स टू बी कवर्ड इन दिस लेक्चर: लिमिटेशन ऑफ ट्रेडिशनल आईपी, देन आफ्टर व्हाट इज द मोबाइल आईपी एंड हाउ मोबाइल आईपी इज वर्किंग। So first of all, what is the mobile IP? Before that, we will just look out for the fundamental of what is the traditional IP and why we requiring the mobile IP. So before that, we will just understand the limitation of the traditional IP. So whenever we are talking about the TCP/IP connection, the TCP/IP connection is basically working on a two basic mode, that is first one is TCP port number and second one is IP address. So now what is the task of this particular two fundamental or two parameter? The first task is of the TCP port number. The TCP port is actually depend on your application. What application data you want to transmit and receive from your sender to receiver. So ultimately, the TCP port number is the fixed number for a particular application and has a constant value. But if we talk about the IP address, then the IP address is basically depend on your network and it can be modified according to your network changes. Same like, even though in IP address we are having two form of IP address, that is IPv4 and IPv6. Okay, so basically when we are talking about what is IP address and what IP addresses are required and how we are assigning the IP address, the network, or you can say the computer network, is basically connected through each nodes or components. What is the end point? The end point is what your nodes. Now what is the end nodes? The end nodes is nothing but your computers, which is connected through the network. Now, ultimately, if we talk about how the network is being formed or connected, we have already discussed this all the fundamental, and you have already learned this topic in your computer network. But we are just brushing out your concept like your nodes or your PCs are connected through the network, and network is connected to each other via one device which is known as router. So ultimately, when we talk about what is router, so router is a kind of device which is connecting different nodes and in a network, right? So ultimately, this routes or this routers is basically having the IP address also, and that IP address is known as the network address. And the PC which you are connected, that particular PC can have the node address. So combination of your network address and node address is combinedly known as IP address. So if we talk about each and every your device is basically having two type of addresses. One is MAC address, that is media access control address, right? And second one is IP address. Now this IP address can be changeable because whenever you are attaching your PC to the network, the point of attachment should be fixed. So ultimately, when you are attaching your PC to any another point, then your IP address can be changed. So basically, obviously the network address can also be changed if you are moving to another network, which is not under your router. If you are moving to another router, then the network address can also be changed. But we are talking about the node address and network address, that is the IP address. IP address can be changed according to point of attachment. So if we talk about the desktop devices, most of already you know that if you talk about the office building premise or your college premise or in your college lab, also there is a multiple PCs connected through the LAN. Right, whenever we talk about that, this LAN is having one cable, that is LAN cable, that is RJ45, right? When we are attaching that RJ45 cable to your connected PC, then IP address will be fixed because the point of connection is okay, right? Point of connection is as it is. But most of the people are nowadays using laptop. So whenever or whatever I want to, whenever I want to use the internet, I can take my laptop and attach it to the any connected port device or RJ45 cable, right? So according to my changing movement, my IP address can also be changed. I am changing my seat, right? So my IP address can also be changed. So this IP address is basically depend on the point of attachment. If we are talking about the laptop or PDA, then point of attachment can be differed. So the IP address can be changed. But when we talk about the Wi-Fi connection, this is all about the wired connection. But if we talk about the Wi-Fi connection, that is a wireless connection, at that type of connection, basically the IP address is changing each and every step we are moving forward. Like I am using the mobile phone at my home where I have set up already my Wi-Fi connection, I have modem and I am having Wi-Fi, right? I am using mobile phone with the internet connection through that Wi-Fi and I am moving. According to my movement, my IP address is not changing because I am having only one point of connection, that is only my modem. But if we talk about a big office premise in which there is multiple modems, or you can say Wi-Fi routers, okay? So whenever I am changing from one Wi-Fi router to another Wi-Fi router, at that time my IP address can be changed. So the concept is clear that what is the TCP and IP, how the TCP port number is being used and how the IP address is being used. So basically if we talk about the mobile IP, so to identify or transfer the data to the perfect device, or we can say perfect receiver, the IP address is very much required, because the sender is sending data according to network address and then after it will find out the node address. If the network is correct, then after it need to find out the node address. So ultimately one IP address must be fixed. And then after, if we talk about the point of attachment is changing, then the second concept of IP address is being in a concern, and that is the what your two type of addressing can be there. One is home address, what is already fixed, and second one is care of address. When you are changing your point of attachment at time, care of address is changing, right? So mobile IP concept is clear. Just we are looking for the, we just see the definition of it. Mobile IP is a communication protocol to allow mobile device user to move from one network to another while maintaining a permanent IP. So this permanent IP address is also known as home IP address. Okay, but we are changing. We are moving. So ultimately mobile IP is also there. So this mobile IP is nothing but your second IP, and that is the care of address. So if we talk about two type of addressing, first one is home address and second one is care of address. The home address is basically given by your home network. Okay, so basically there is two type of fundamental. One type is home network and second type is foreign network. When we are talking about home network, your first IP address or the permanent IP address is given by your home network. So your network address can be according to your home network only. Okay, I am only talking about network address. Okay, not whole IP address. So your network address is basically depend on your home network, and that home network is giving you a node number also, and combining with the network address and node address, you can have the IP address. So ultimately your home address is given by your home network. If we talk about the second type, that is care of address, the care of address is basically given by the foreign network. Okay, care of address is given by the foreign network, and this care of address must be registered to your home network. Okay, this care of address must be registered to your home network. So whenever you are roaming somewhere, so your permanent IP address is your home address, right? So any of the data which is to be sent to you will be first sent to your home network, and home network can already have the care of address if you are roaming in another foreign network. Okay, how this fundamental is basically working, we will see this in very much of detail. So the concept is clear, the home address is static and known to everybody, but the care of address is a new point of attachment and it can be registered to your home network by your device. So before going forward to the how does the mobile IP work, just I need to clarify that there should be four addresses that most, that is in TCP IP connection. First one is TCP port number of your transmitter, then after IP address of your transmitter, then IP address of your receiver and port number of your receiver. These four parameter must be constant or static. These four parameter must be constant or static. But if any of them is changing, then you can have lost the connection or you can have lost the data. So ultimately, these four must be static. But if we talk about the receiver which is movable, then at that time your receiver IP address can be changed, which should be fixed, and that we are considering according to the home address. Okay, care of address is changing, we are not concerned with it, but we are having the home address. So this is the whole concept of your mobile IP. So how does the mobile IP work? See, in this diagram, you can also ask that what is the mobile IP architecture, but we are looking this particular concept by one example only, in which mobile node A is having the home network for A and foreign network this B. Okay, this is the foreign network B and this is the home network A. So ultimately, if we talk about this mobile node A, which is having the home network in A, mobile node A is right now roaming in a foreign network. It is not currently in a home network. Suppose it is roaming in a foreign network. Okay, and any server X wants to send data to the mobile node A. So the server X will send data according to the home address, or we can say according to the network address and node address combination. And that will be actually, we will use what? Home address, because home address is public and known to everybody. So ultimately, server X will send data directly to the home agent. Now the home agent will check that your mobile node A is in the same network or in the foreign network. It will look for the database, and in database, if care of address is there, then it will be in a foreign network. If care of address is not there, then it is in a home network. If it is in a home network, then data will be directly transmitted to your mobile node A. Okay? But suppose it is in a foreign network, okay, which is actually our example, it is in a foreign network. So ultimately, your home agent will now check for the care of address. Now, what it will do, it will recapsulate the packet, okay. It will again encapsulate the packet, and then after it will send data to the foreign agent. Likewise, this is the sender and this is this receiver, but actual sender is server X. Okay, server X is sending data to home agent. So ultimately, server X is a sender and home agent is a receiver. But home agent identifies that the mode mobile node A is in a foreign network. So now it will by itself become the sender and foreign agent will be the receiver. okay, sender and receiver. So ultimately home agent will again encapsulate the data, and then after it will send the data to the foreign agent. Now foreign agent will decapsulate the packet, and then after it will send that actual packet to the mobile node A. So to understand this whole process, ultimately we need to consider three basic step. That is, first step is discovery, second step is registration, and third step is tunneling. Discovery means that how the network node or home node will identify that your mobile node is currently in a home agent or home network or in a foreign network. Okay, that is the discovery process. Then after the registration process, how the mobile node will send the care of address to the actual home network to make it identify that he is not right now in a home network but in anywhere another foreign network. And then after the tunneling process, which I have already told you, that the packet is firstly being sent from your server X to your home agent or home network, right? And then after, home agent will again send that data, kind of he is the sender, and it will forward that data to the foreign network. So ultimately this whole process is known as the tunneling process. So how this tunneling process is being executed? This is the basic three step: discovery process, registration process, and tunneling process. So here look in your again diagram. Server X is sending data to home agent, home agent is sending data to foreign agent, and foreign agent is sending data to the mobile node A, which is in a right now roaming area of your foreign network. Now the mobile node A wants to send response to server X. Mobile node A wants to send response to server X. So ultimately server X is a fixed point of attachment. It is not roaming anywhere, right? And we are having the address of it also because it was the actual sender. So ultimately now your mobile node A will again encapsulate the packet, and mobile node A now will be the sender and server X will be the receiver. Now for sending data again back to server X, the mobile or node A does not need to follow the original path. Okay, wherever he is, it can send data directly to server X. So ultimately mobile node A is sending data to the foreign agent, and foreign agent is sending data directly to the server X, and server X is getting the response. So basically three step or three process are there: discovery process, then after registration process, and then after tunneling process. So summary of this lecture, we understood about the limitation of the traditional IP because four basic parameter, which are TCP port number and of sender and IP address of sender, TCP port number of receiver and IP port number of receiver, four should be static. But if we talk about if we are moving as a mobile, then IP address is also becoming the mobile. The point of attachment is also a mobile. So at that time, traditional IP is not in a use. So we need or we require the mobile IP. And the mobile IP is working in basically three processes, that is tunneling, registration, and discovery. So we will understand all this process in very much of detail in next lecture. Thank you. We will meet in our next lecture.